Good morning, Lions. I'm Taryn.
And I'm Morgan Reed Salisbury.
And this is
the Lions Roar.
Today's date is Monday, April 22nd, 2024.
Happy Earth Day, Lions.
I'm just saying, you know, you're a senior and I'm a junior. You will be missed.
Okay, well, let's get right into this Monday's announcements.
Mud volleyball is coming up on May 5th at Broken Arrow Park. Contact Miss Solution in room 154 if you have any questions and sign up at lunch.
Environmental Club is celebrating Earth Day. Talk to Miss Ball in room 197 for more info. And if you're wearing green today, pick up some candy at lunch.
And Thursday, come to Miss Ball's room at 315 for a presentation from our Kansas State Senator, Marcy Francisco. There will also be snacks, crafts, and games.
Next week will be Pride Club Spirit Week. Monday will be Pride Flag Day. Tuesday is Pronoun Day. Wednesday is Comfort and Stuffy. Thursday is Royalty Day. And Friday is Rainbow Day. Be sure to show off your pride, Lions.
Finally, remember that Showtime premieres this Thursday. Here's Karen Middleton with a preview along with some more videos from around the school.
This week, the choir is putting on its annual Showtime concert. The show features many unique performances put together by LHS students. Choir director Dwayne Dunn shares what Showtime is.
Showtime is a variety show that's put on by the choral music students, the advanced choirs at Lawrence High. And it's been going for well over 40 years. Students put together acts, they choose the music, they choreograph them, they stage them, they costume them, they audition for the show, and then the best acts are chosen. And then some of the advanced choirs do some numbers along with it, and it makes about a 2.5 hour entertainment evening.
Showtime singers Tony Jacobson and Julia Ventello are a part of multiple performing groups. This entails lots of preparation and practice.
I have a few songs, but I'll say my favorite is Never Say Never. It's a group of six of us. We have some dancing, we have some solos and some cool flips. You gotta come see it.
I'm in a bunch of different acts, actually. I auditioned to be in four featured acts, and luckily they all got in. It definitely took a lot of preparation. There were a lot of rehearsals that started like even before winter break a little bit, and then we just built up as much as we could before auditions in like February, I think. But it definitely takes a lot of like extracurricular time outside of the school day.
Showtime allows choir students to pick the songs they want to perform and explore different genres of music.
The thing I enjoy the most about Showtime is being able to like find a group to make music with, because we get to make our own music and it's not just what the normal choir just picks.
We get to do a variety of styles, so we have like pop, country, musical theater, rock maybe, and like there's even some stuff from like TV shows. Really a wide variety of genres.
The show is fun and exciting for students performing and audience members who attend.
It's kind of made by the students for the students, so it's not like just another choir concert. It's really just like a big party on stage for like 2 hours with like a bunch of really fun songs.
Students should go see Showtime because it's fun, great music, and it's your favorite seniors and juniors from choir, and they get to perform for you, so yeah, it's pretty big.
This has been a big tradition at Lawrence High, and it's something that the entire Lawrence High community comes out and supports, and so I encourage you to get your tickets. They're available in the finance office or at Hy-Vee Grocery Store. You can get them in advance, or you can buy them at the door. They cost 10 bucks. It'll be 10 bucks well spent, because you'll really have a great time at Showtime.
Showtime will be in the auditorium this Thursday, Friday, and Saturday at 7:30 p.m. Make sure to attend and support the choir department.
This has been Karen Middleton, reporting for the Lions Roar.
Earth Day is our world's biggest secular holiday, but how did it begin? In 1969, after a massive oil spill and several popular speeches by Senator Gaylord Nelson, the soon-to-be founder of Earth Day, he was able to convince Washington politicians of the importance of our Earth's health. And just a few decades later, in 1990, Earth Day would finally go global. But how do you celebrate Earth Day? In America, we mostly hold small festivals and marches depending on where you live. But that's not the only Earth Day tradition in the books. In Canada, they plant trees, and in the Philippines, they encourage their citizens to commit to climate health, And in Rome, a multiple-day festival takes place in Villa Borghese. There are so many traditions, so celebrate however you want and make sure you recycle. Have a great day, Chesties.
Natasha Torkziban has played several roles across our school, like being part of the LHS budget, participating in the LHS Color Guard, Winter Court, and other things.
As a journalist, a lot of the times we get to tell other people's stories, and that's really what drives us. And so a lot of the times I've encountered story subjects and people who have interesting things about them that we could write about. I recently just wrote a story about Goldie Stevens, about her wrestling thing, so it was really fun.
Natasha has helped the budget in many ways and has made a lot of friends along her stay.
Whenever she goes around, you just see her happy and always encouraging people to do their best, and she advocates for everyone here and makes them seen, gives them a voice to be heard.
As graduation nears, Natasha has big plans for what lies ahead and has support from her friends in the LHS community for her next big step.
I hope that Nat becomes the greatest lawyer of all time and the best journalist in the world, so then I can use her for my own benefit.
Having just read some of her essays applying for college, that I cannot wait to read her personal memoir someday, because she has rich list of experiences that make her life very extraordinary and something that it's going to be a good book to read.
I've done a lot of things here this year that have been fostered by the incredible culture and community here, and so it's really built my confidence to be able to advocate for myself and just to be able to hone in on those skills.
This has been Danny Phalen and Liam McCoy reporting for the Lions Roar.
My name is Emily Ryan Brandt. Through my activities, I've made some of my best friends here, and it's also made me feel super comfortable being in the school and being around a bunch of different people.
She's an inspiration to us all.
She's cheering, and she's diving, and she's learning how to play the trumpet, and it's like, wow.
She's very social. She does a lot of things, and so by being friends with her, it's sort of pulled me into doing more things and talking to more people.
She happened to just pick up her friend's trumpet and just started playing it, told her that another person was better than she was. But actually, she took that as a challenge to like get really good at the trumpet. And look at her now. I mean, she's like second chair in the wind ensemble. That's pretty incredible.
I think I'm such a better person because of band, and it's definitely like helped me be a more social person and like be okay with like making mistakes and things like that. Broken me out of my shell, I would say. And Mr. Jones is just the kindest person ever.
All right, well, that's all for today. Make sure to tune in to this Friday's episode during Fifth Hour. And remember, it's a great day to be a lion.